finished your assignment problem and we
L 1 5.
So
that's one entering the property. The L function that is for non-trivial calculus doesn't have a port. And but that's not the, well, it will play a very critical role later on, as we see. Now let's move forward. So this is the L function for different characters, which is analogous of zeta function. And like in zeta function, it has a functional equation. That also played a very critical role. So let's check out what are the properties of zeta function that we use. Firstly, that it has a pole at 1. That played a crucial role. If you recall the, when we looked at poles of zeta prime or zeta, it had a pole at 1, so that created a certain residue. That residue was x, and then there were other residues. Similarly, we'll do the same exercise for L function. So anyway, that was first thing about zeta function. Second was this connection between the psi and the zeta function. You know, integral psi being written as integral of L prime, zeta prime or zeta or something. Third was this functional equation for the zeta function, which allowed us to analytically extend it over the entire thing. And what else? What other property of zeta function? Well, that's it. And then we looked at actually this functional equation allowed us to also write this, express zeta function as zeta function as a Hadamard product. And that was very useful in analyzing the growth rate of zeta function or zeta prime or zeta along the lines we had taken. So be the growth for the order log r. So these are the basic things that one did for the zeta function, and we'll do essentially the same thing for the other. The first thing we already seen, the behavior at z equals 1. Now let's come to the functional equation. Say that one just mostly follows what we did for zeta function. Now, if you remember, how did we arrive at the functional equation? We started with the gamma function. You start with gamma function. Gamma of being integral from 0 to infinity of
e to the z.
That is gone. And then we say, okay, let's replace e by something. E to the minus. And we said replace t by
pi n square u.
And then gamma z becomes 0 to infinity pi n square u to the z. Just taking things that don't fit the integral out, you get pi to the z and to the to z
What?
The composite pipe.
So we looked at composite pipe. So there we get pi to the z plus 2 into the z. Integral 0 to infinity, root to the infinity, root to the 1. And then therefore we get and now we say sum over all x. And that gives a zeta function on the left hand side, the integral on the right hand side, and then we do the analysis on the right hand side and say derive some problem. But now we want to do the same thing for L functions. So up to this point it's the same, no difference. But now instead of summing over all n's, what we do instead do is, we recall the definition of the L function. You first multiply it with chi of n and then sum over. That's it. And then you look at this summation, and earlier we played around with the summation without chi of n multiplied, but now we have chi of n also multiplied. But the analysis of this summation is exactly the same as we did it for. And the fact that chi of n is multiplicative makes everything go through very smoothly. There is hardly any difference. There is one minor difference that we will encounter as we do the analysis. So to cater for that, we'll have to do slightly differently for our aspect. So let me split the characters into two types: odd character chi of these are the only two possibilities for a character. Now, minus 1 would either map it to minus 1 or plus 1. That follows from the multiplicative property. Chi of minus 1 whole square is 1. So, chi of minus 1 is 1. So, depending on whether it is minus 1 or plus 1, we divide it into these two groups. Now, for one of these, let me put the question to you. In this sum, do you see a problem for one of these two types? I believe for event character this should be fine. This is almost. Okay, minus 1. For one of these two types, this doesn't quite work out. Once you start doing the analysis of this sum, you'll realize yourself. So I'll leave that to you. is equal to, let's say, 1 minus z. Okay, so let's define. So first define this in the same fashion. This one is, what is this? Zai?
Kai.
Kai. Kai is it. This is also fine.
How do we write Kai?
Oh, that's Zai.
Zai, like this Zai. So Zai or Zai. Zai or Z Kai. It's the same, exactly as in Zeta function. So letting this Zai or Z Kai is equal to tau of pi divided by phi root of q. So this is the function. There are some new things which are coming here. One is this tau of chi, which I'll define in a moment what this is, divided by square root q times xi of 1 minus z, and then this character changes to the chi bar. Chi bar is the inverse of chi. Remember, the characters form a group. So chi bar is simply the inverse of character. And so the only unexplained thing here is tau. Tau of chi, this is a famous quantity, a well-known quantity. It's called Gauss sum for a character. This is equal to, I am going from 1 to q of e to the power 2 pi I. So these Gauss sums play a very, very important role when in character analysis in general. But I'll not dwell into this. Just say that Gauss sum occurs as a multiplier in the function convention. And all of this you can just derive. Just follow almost blindly what we did earlier. So these things will just fall out of it naturally. Of course, you will have to use those properties of character I listed last time, right, the various sum properties. And that's all. You don't have to do anything new. Okay. So that's for even characters. For odd characters, it changes a little bit.
What's u in the last theorem?
What?
Q.
Q is that modulus. The character, the whole character is defined as a map of ZQ star to complex space. So Q is that implicitly everywhere is present. Actually, I should be writing chi of Q, but that's just painful to write chi of Q anyway. So Q is, again, one universal number fixed once and for all. So if it is an odd character, then one needs to change the definition of xi a bit. This is so there is this plus one. So basically one has to start with gamma of z over 2 plus 1 here and then sum over, because this sum doesn't quite work out very nice, but the opposing sum doesn't work out very nice. inference is there is an I. So again, these funny things just pop out of the analysis. So this defines the functional equation for the L function. And using the functional equation now, we can see that all the L functions can be extended over the entire complex. Once you extend it over the entire complex plane, then again you can talk about the zeros everywhere. So what would be the zeros of this L function? Again, these are governed by the gamma. The zeros of gamma functions are at negative integers. Sorry, the poles of negative integers. They are all of order 1. So the L function, the trivial zeros of the L function will be at negative even integers. Right? So those are trivial zeros, just as in case of zero function. And then there are non-trivial zeros, which are again between the strip of 0 and 1. Beyond 1, there are no zeros. Now, what about zeros here of this L function for odd characters? These are all negative odd integers, right? Those are trivial zeros. And again, the non trivial zeros will be between the strip 0 and 1. Everything works out in the same way. You can do the rest of the analysis in exactly the same way. That is, this, okay, and should talk about the rest of the analysis. So, this completely describes the L functions. Now, I need to relate the psi with the L function. And the method used is again exactly the same. But there is one intermediate step, which is which are this so again this is the cousin of psi. For psi of x is just sum over n less than equal to x of lambda n. And psi of x chi is summation n less than equal to chi of n times lambda. Okay, so this is a quantity which we will use, which we will relate to the L functions. And finally, recall what is our target? Our target is estimate this. So this is a different psi. And this is what we really want. But in order to understand this or extract out information about this, we are going to use L function, and first we'll relate L function with this psi, this version of psi for this particular character. Because that psi has no characters, it just has a residual. So I'll show you once I'm done with it how to relate that psi with this psi. But let's first go ahead with this. And the relationship between this and L function is exactly again the same. How did we derive this relationship with that L function? With the zeta function? Well, we just go ahead with the same process. This is same as n greater than or equal to 1, I of n, lambda of n, and then delta of x by n. Right? And then stick the integral for the delta function, take everything inside. Now, because everything, everywhere this chi of n is multiplying, as a multiplier is present, the integral that you will get will have, after a bit of work, it will be 1 over 2 pi I integral, and this goes from
minus I infinity to C plus I infinity minus L prime delta phi over L delta phi x to be z by z. This one. The only change is that the zeta prime or zeta is replaced by L prime. And again, we do the same thing. We can approximate this C minus IR to C plus IR. That same function or expression for error will come. And now that we know L prime over L, and we do the same analysis using functional equation for L prime over L, and then write this in terms of various poles of this. And what we will get is eventually psi of x chi 0. So there will be not a difference between the trivial character and non-trivial character. And that difference will come precisely because of the pole being present at z equals 1 for trivial character. It being absent for z equals 1 and the non-trivial characters. And that's very crucial because this has a pole at z equals 1, so the residue of that comes out to be x. And if we recall, the x was the leading term. I mean, that residue is what really gives the main value to psi. The rest of the residues are just errors. Okay. So for the trivial character, that residue is present. Plus, there will be again the same thing, the sum over all non-trivial zeros and trivial zeros and the similar corresponding expression. So let me just bring that in my error. And psi of x chi, where chi is not equal to chi naught. Now this residue is not present there, it is just error. Okay, and here error is taken to mean that whatever that expression was, the order, this is basically but let me write. Now I will write the error when I done with the generalized hypothesis. So now there is a version of Riemann hypothesis, because Riemann hypothesis determines what exactly this error is. So now there is a version of Riemann hypothesis for L functions, and which is the following. Exactly same statement as the Riemann hypothesis, except that instead of zeta function, we are not talking about the for different characters. And this hypothesis says, well, no matter what the character we choose, all non-trivial zeros of the corresponding L function lie on that line. We are there. And if this is true, is true, then psi of x of chi 0 is x plus order q square root x log. So the error is same, but except that multiplier q comes in again because of calculations. And psi of x chi equal to chi 0 is simply just here. Right? So this is what we get just doing the everything we did before for here. Good. But that still hasn't yet answered our original question, which was about that psi. See, this is psi of the second variant version of psi, right? Psi of a character. But we are not interested in psi of a character. We are interested in counting this psi, which is sum n less than equal to x, and n being congruent to a mod q of lambda. That's a quantity that exists. So how does one relate this psi to the character psi? So again, this sum over, sum ends which are sort of jumping over the groups, one stays within a residue class, A mod Q. This is messier to analyze, so we'd like to avoid it and replace it with the sum over all ends to X. And there is a simple mechanism available for it. Let's just consider first. We just consider psi of n. What is this? Pi bar of x times sum n less than equal to x pi of now, what is chi bar of A times chi of N? See, because chi is multiplicative, chi bar of A is 1 over chi of N. Okay. And again, using multiplicative property, chi of N times chi divided by chi of A is chi of N. And now, what I want to do is sum over all chi's. So there is a group of characters, sum it over all. What is this? Change the sums. Now, what do we know about this sum?
Whenever
n is a, this is chi of 1. Or let's say, not just a, whenever n is a mod q. That was the extended definition. If it is the same residue class, it comes to the same. So whenever n is a modulo q, you get chi of 1.
and summing over all characters, you get phi of q. On the other end, when if n is not equal to a, so modulo q, then what is this sum?
Zero.
So this is equal to n less than equal to x, n is a mod q, which is precisely the quantity.
Shouldn't there be a phi of q?
This is a therefore, psi of x sum over all characters, psi bar of k times psi of
how does phi of q come in?
Sorry, phi of q, how does it come?
Okay. Yeah.
Phi of q.
When n is a mod q,
yeah,
then this is chi of 1. And then you're summing over all characters in the group.
Yeah.
Chi of 1 is always 1. The number of characters in the group is exactly
1. Chi of 1 over all characters.
Sorry?
Chi of 1 over all
characters. Chi of 1 over all characters. So that you get there for phi of q. So that's the expression, and which is very nice because now we get this very clearly. That is, we know what psi of x chi is. Okay. Psi of x chi is, so let's split this sum into chi 0 and not chi 0. So this is 1 over psi of q, psi of x, chi naught, plus 1 over psi of q, psi naught, chi naught, chi naught. We know this. This is essentially x over pi q plus the error. And this is whole of it is error. So this is essentially the error anyway. And the error was square root x q log square x. Well, of course, this gets multiplied by this, but this is absolute value 1. So if you just take absolute value of the error and get rid of this, the sum over all of this, but that sum is same as this, so that sort of cancels out, and you get order square root x q and that's it. What we started out to. Now this is assuming GRH, but the same technique we used to prove the prime number theorem. More or less the same technique can be used to prove the similar theorem about this, that is psi of x a q is x over phi q plus times 1 over small o of 1. So this error is not this small, but is small o of 1 without any assumption. Any questions on this? I went through pretty rapidly because it's really repeating everything we did again. You can try this for the heck of it, try working out some of the steps I expect to see by yourself. Now this, of course, might appear, what's the point, I mean, it's a slightly more generalization of it, but this has a number of interesting applications, this particular result of psi of NCQ. I want to point out a couple of them to justify that this course is a computer science course. Couple of computer science applications of this theorem under generalizing analysis. In fact, this is used very heavily in just about not every but most of the number theoretic algorithms in computer science. For example, it was used to show that primality testing is indeed. It was used to show that certain univariate polynomial factorization under certain conditions is well, not quite NP, but there's n to the log n time number, and number of other cases. They all arise out of this result. And the way it comes out is actually pretty simple. So these are the bottom line to all of this is that if you take a subgroup of ZQ star, okay, then and you want to find an element in ZQ star which is not in that subgroup, then you don't have to look. You don't have to search too much for that element. So let me just summarize it here. So H is a proper subgroup of ZQ star, and as I said, we are looking for an element outside this subgroup. All we need to do is start from 1, 2, 3, 4, go up to log n to the log q to the 4. One of these will be an element outside. Okay. Now we will prove it. Can you see how using the okay, better still, I am out of time anyway. Let's give this, no, I will not give it an assignment because this is very interesting and I want to do it, make sure that you understand it. So I will give it as homework and we will do it in the next one.